In this short video, we're going to look at the proof of the fact that the first derivative of the natural log of x equals 1 over x. Now, it's one of those proofs in mathematics that really doesn't come naturally and truthfully doesn't sit well. There's one expression or equation that we need to know beforehand, and that is when we looked at the definition of Euler's number. And I'm going to write that in red, and we can come back to it. And it states that Euler's number, or one of the definitions at least of Euler's number, is the limit as n goes to infinity of 1 plus 1 over n to the power n. That is one of the definitions of Euler's number. Well, let's start off with the proof. We know that there is a way using limits to get to the first order derivative, and certainly we can rewrite, well, let's say d dx of the natural log of x, that would be the same as saying the limit as delta x goes to 0 of the natural log of x plus delta x minus the natural log of x. Let me get something to draw a straight line with. That'll be over delta x. That is the way that we used to look at, or that you used to look at, first derivatives using limits right at the start of learning calculus. Now, we can use the properties of logarithms, which we have looked at before, and we can rewrite this as the limit as delta x goes to 0. We can bring this the denominator delta x, we can bring that to the front, and let's say that is 1 over delta x. 1 over delta x. And we have natural log and natural log, so that's actually log base Euler's number. So we can use the property of division for the natural log here. So that's natural log of x plus delta x over x. And I can rewrite that as the limit as delta x approaches 0 of 1 over delta x of the natural log of 1 plus delta x over x. Now I can use my property of exponents and take this and make it the exponent, or the power. So that's the limit as delta x approaches 0 of the natural log of 1 plus delta x over x to the power 1 over delta x. Let's give ourselves a new page. That's good. Now we're going to do one of those things that might not sit what might not come too naturally. And we're going to substitute delta x over x with another value that might make things a bit easier for us, and we're going to call it 1 over n. It's just an arbitrary decision that we've made. We're going to express delta x over x in a new way, and we're going to call that new expression 1 over n. With a bit of algebra, I can say thus that delta x equals x over n. I've just divided both sides, multiplied both sides with x, I should say. Now, if you look at this expression, let me rewrite it here and do it in red. If I say that the delta x equals x over n, what happens if delta x approaches 0? So if I would say the limit as delta x approaches 0, of delta x, well, this left hand side will become 0. How do we make the right hand side 0? Well, that would be the same as saying the limit as n approaches infinity of x over n. A number like x divided by infinity, an infinitely large number, approaches 0. So as I've made delta x approach 0 on the left hand side, that would be the same as taking the limit as n approaches infinity of the right hand side. So by substituting this value for delta x over x, instead of taking the limit as delta x equals 0, I can now take the limit as n approaches infinity. So watch as I rewrite this, and although it is very non-intuitive, understand what I'm doing so that it makes at least a little bit of sense. So that would be the same as the limit as n approaches infinity of the natural log of 1 plus, now delta x over x, I've said is 1 over n, and I have to the power of 1 over delta x, so 1, I'm going to just rewrite it here in red, so 1 over delta x, but delta x we've said is x over n, so 1 over delta x is going to be n over x, so that was just swapping around. So this is going to be to the power n over x. I can rewrite this as the limit as n approaches infinity of the, I'm going to put this out here, natural log of 1 plus 1 over n, that is to the power n, and that is to the power 1 over x. So that is just an exponent rule from normal algebra. If I multiply the n by 1 over x, it stays n over x. I haven't changed anything there. Now, I can use the law of logarithms. Because I have an exponent, I can bring that exponent out. So I can say the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 over x times the natural log of 1 plus 1 over n to the power n. Now we start seeing the light. If we just look back right at the top, if I can get there, here was an expression or an equation for definition of Euler's number. Now 1 over x, if you think about taking a limit as n approaches infinity, 1 over x is not going to change. It might as well be a constant. And we can bring it outside of our limit. As n approaches infinity, nothing about x changes. So that'll be the limit as n approaches infinity of the natural log of 1 plus 1 over n to the power n. And that is 1 over x. Now, as the next step is another counterintuitive step. And the way that it is explained in textbooks is that as taking the limit as n approaches infinity is concerned about this element of our function. That is the part where n approaches 0. So we can swap out these two parts and say that is the natural log of the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 plus 1 over n to the power n. And as we said right at the start, that at least this part is a definition for Euler's number e. So we have 1 over x natural log of e, which is 1, and that leaves us with 1 over x. A very counterintuitive, difficult, and slightly uneasy proof of the fact that the first derivative of the natural log of x equals 1 over x.